Okay. Let's go e4 again. Yeah, I think I played this guy just a couple of days ago. And okay, let's play the Open Sicilian. Okay, knight off. Not sure what I should play there. Let's go for some positional line. At least at the beginning. We'll get sharp soon enough, I think. Yeah, this is the classical setup where this Skeveningen variation, which we transposed into. This was the, one of the main battlegrounds in the early 80s matches between Kasparov and Karpov. And that's about the only thing I know. Somehow I didn't play King H1, which they have almost always play. Okay, but I don't know really the details. I would need to look this up in a database or book or something. Yeah, black wants to prevent white's a5. Okay, I play this after all. Okay, this is also a typical maneuver because the knight needs d7 as a retreat square, and the bishop was bad on d7, of course. So is this one of those positions where you play g4? I think so. Now the typical maneuver is to swing the queen over, and a rook to h3, king queen to h5. I tried to do that. It's the normal way this is played, but not. Of course, I never had this on the board, so it's interesting. He's trying for counterplay on c2. Understandable. So, what is this? Should I cover this? Rook c1 looks really passive. Not sure if I want to play a move like that. Queen h4, he will play h5 and use this bishop. Of course, and then have the automatic sacrifice on h5, but he's really quick there on c2. Maybe I need to spend this tempo after all. I didn't like to, but don't see a direct way to make progress. At least if he plays bishop f8 now, I maybe have queen h4, and then h5 I could capture. That's not the end of the world for black, but it's something. Okay, he might have some tricks now. On e4 or something. Not sure. Don't think this is a threat particularly. Let's try this very crude bishop sacrifice maneuver. Okay, let's check quickly. I take here, takes, queen takes, bishop g7, then maybe bishop d4. Threatens immediate mate on h8, cannot take. And on e5, I play. Can I play f5? Takes f6. Wow. Could be made. Think this is one of those cases where the bridges are already burnt. I maybe can take on maybe you can take on e4 at some point. This looks like dangerous counterplay. E4 of course is the weak spot here. But first of all, I think he needs to play e5. E5, okay. But I can actually take on c5 with the bishop, maybe. And then f5. Is this possible? And then f6, yeah. Okay, f6 is really a strong threat. What can he do? F6 himself, maybe, but can I just take and rook g1? King f8. Or rook g1 first to have this threat on f6. He takes on g5. Now I play rook g5, threatening queen h8 again. Okay, let's think first. If I take on f6 now, he needs to take with the queen. Maybe this is I think more exact. And then f6. I also just he cannot
Time warning.
f6, yeah. Now queen something, queen h7. Everything wins, I guess.
Check. Check.
Queen f5.
Checkmate.
Okay. Yeah, this was a nice direct attack. Not sure if it was sound, but it was looking dangerous. Maybe he can take on e4 now with a knight or something. My computer also wants to take. Let's check this quickly. Bishop g7, of course. d4, e5. Bishop takes. Oh well, this is just great. What's this? The computer now. The computer now gives knight a2 for black with a 0-0-0. What? Okay, then this attack was was great because knight a2 No human would ever play this. At least not not in a blitz game. This is just an insane move. Yeah, the idea if I take it, then bishop e4 is a check, and this also this bishop e4 also covers h7, so I don't have a direct threat. And of course, with the e4 pawn gone, I cannot play f5. Ah, after some calculating, the computer actually gives knight a2 with a rather clear advantage to white. Yeah, then this attack was just working. Knight a2, rook e1. I simply I cannot here in on ICC. I'm not able to make variations and show moves on the board. I think it's possible, but I don't know how it's done. So, yeah, interesting. Maybe I'll look at this a bit afterwards and do some analysis in a separate video. This is really cool position. Okay, took with the b pawn. And f5, yeah, it's now this is just winning. The comp gives this as plus 5. Let's check if I executed this correctly. F6. Now the comp wants to take, but rook g1, yeah, it's equally good. Okay, this is this is good. King f, yeah, then just taking and rook g6. Yeah, I played this correctly. Fine. Of course, you cannot calculate this stuff in blitz, but yeah, maybe I do a separate video. This was really cool. Yeah, well, you don't get games like this with 1g3 or something. So fun game for a change. Yeah, thanks for watching. Leave any questions or comments here, and make sure to subscribe if you want to get informed about new videos. Thanks, and see you next game.